Well, Maitreya's allegations have raked up a storm not only in the political circles but across the country. While many doubts have been raised on the authenticity of the accusations, the starlet spoke exclusively to News9 in an attempt to clear the air, but in the process she made some startling revelations. Is it really a love saga gone wrong, or is there a political angle to this mess? Take a look.
I have with me Maitri Gowda here. Maitri, exactly tell us what has happened. You've heard several allegations on Karthik Gowda. Tell us exactly what is the scene.
Karthik Gowda and me, we both have got married on 5th of June this year. From then, we both were good. We were talking nicely over the phone. Then later, July 21st, I didn't get my proper chum, so I got scared actually. Then I told him about this. He said, go check with the doctor. Then I told him that I don't know about all this. I can't go. You also have to come with me. He said, I am not the blame. You don't blame me. You only go and do all such things. Then from then, he was not talking to me properly. Then he used to love me so much. He was like, take care of me well, all that. Then after telling this thing, he was like avoiding me so much. He was not talking to me properly. So I actually kind of went under stress actually, why he is doing like this. He was not calling my number from then, but he used to receive my calls whenever I used to call, and he used to tell that I'm busy with my work. So let me concentrate on work. If I give you more time, I can't concentrate on my work. Then he didn't receive my call. 7th and 7th he spoke to me. 8th was a festival. I called him to home. He said, if I'm free, I'll come. And 8th and 9th, he didn't receive my call. Then 10th, I called home to talk to his mother. They said they are not in town. They have been to Madikeri. Then I took her mobile number and I tried talking to her. Then she said, Karthik is here. We have come for our family function. Then she said, what was the issue? What do you want to talk? I said, auntie, something personal. I want to talk to you. When you are coming, I will meet you. Then next day she called me at 1 o'clock. Then I thought if I go 1 o'clock, Karthik will be not there because he used to go to office at 11:30. So I went at 11:30. She told, called you to come at 1 o'clock, but you're coming at 11:30. You were spoiling all my day, that this thing and all. Then I told her, auntie, nothing to be scared. I'm not came here to, you know, I'm not come with any media, or I'm not here to blackmail you or anything. Don't take it serious. I just want to tell you what all the things was happened between me and Karthik. Then she said, you all know that 6 years back he was not well. He met an accident. That time we suffered so much to, you know, make him healthy. He was not recognizing us for 2 years and all. She said, okay, auntie, that all the issues I know because he has spoken to me about all that and all. And Karthik used to tell me that his mother knew me because she used to check his phone. That time she had seen my photograph and she asked, who is this girl? She's good looking and all. So that's how she knew. That's what Karthik had told. When I went to meet her, the thing was that she's already knew about my incident. That way only she behaved. And she know the whole incident kind of.
What incident did she know exactly? Did you test positive? Were you pregnant?
No, I was not conceived, but I got 5 days delay my chums.
Okay.
So I don't know what went wrong. Later he was not talking to me properly. Then I tried to talk to his mother, I went to home and I told her, I can't take this as a, you know, you both have not came to me before, you not asked us about this. Now we can't accept it, this marriage. You better carry on with your work.
How did he marry you? You said you're married. How?
I went to Mangalore on 5th of June. That time he was like, before that also he used to force me to have a physical relationship with me. So I never agreed. I used to tell him that this is not fair. We should not move on before marriage. This should not happen before marriage. So you better introduce me to your parents first, let them like me, and if they give positive opinion, then I will listen to you whatever you say. But he seriously wanted me when I went to Mangalore also. He called, I will take you to temple, come and all. There also he forced me so much. Then I told him, no, before marriage I can't be close to you. Then he said, that is a thing, no. Now anyways, I have accepted you as a wife. And he was introducing all his friends, saying she's my wife. Then he tied this Mangal Sutra, saying, now see, you wanted to get married, no? So I got married to you. Now I have all the rights on you. You should listen to me, whatever I say.
Did your parents know about it, that this had happened? He married you or he tied the Mangal Sutra?
This I didn't tell anyone, because he took a promise saying that you should not tell to anyone. This has to be between you and me. Till I talk to my parents or introduce them, and till we get married in a public. So that's how I couldn't tell to anyone about the marriage issue.
Okay. There are a few, now you filed a serious charge against Karthik Gowda. It is almost on the basis of rape. Also, you had medical tests that were done. Lately, we heard that, through the course of the day, we also heard that the medical tests did not show that you were raped. What exactly happened?
I don't know how you got this information about the medical test, because so far we are only have not got the medical test report, because as if while she doctor was testing, she told there is a cut mark and all.
Okay.
So that's how
she told you.
Yeah.
That. Okay.
So it is, can't be negative.
But now what, Maitri? Are you looking for justice? Do you want him to be punished? What kind of justice are you looking at?
We have actually got married, so why the reason I filed FIR is I seriously need him in my life. I just can't take anyone else like my husband, or I have no other thought except Karthik Gowda. So I need him, so because of that I have filed the FIR. Now I request their parents that please take me as your daughter-in-law. And